Good morning, friends and fellow traders. This is Doug Campbell with Right Way Options, and this is the morning market prep video for October 23rd, 2024. Well, I hope everyone had a great evening, ready for another wild day of earnings in the market. Yesterday, we had quite the volatility with a drop and then a rally back up, but unfortunately, this morning we're looking back on a little bit of bearishness here this morning. So the problem is we continue to see bond yields rising, really in disagreement with this market rally. So we're going to have to keep a pretty close eye on that as we progress throughout this week. Something is going to have to give here eventually. If we take a look at what happened overnight, Asian markets were mostly higher overnight. We had the Nikkei and India down, while most everything else was up. Australia, South Korea, Hong Kong, Shanghai, all looking higher last night. As a matter of fact, Hong Kong had a pretty nice day, up 1.27% on the day. So looking better over there. If we take a look at European markets this morning, however, we're red across the board. DAX is down 0.32%, FTSE's down 0.38%, CAC is down 0.78%. And one of the things that they are focused on are those bond yields here in the United States. If we take a look at U.S. futures here this morning, U.S. futures, big reversal overnight on this. We've got Dow futures at the moment down 207. We've got NASDAQ futures down 1525, and S&P futures 1525, and NASDAQ futures down 7950 as earnings begin to roll in. As a matter of fact, we just got a report from Coca-Cola. They topped estimates here, but they're suggesting maybe sluggish demand here on Coke. So kind of keep an eye on some of these tickers this morning. There's a lot of earnings. We'll cover that in just a moment. Let's take a look at what is happening in bonds here this morning. Our bond yields this morning, the two-year bond has moved up to 4.05%, the 10-year bond up to 4.22%, and the 30-year bond is 4.51% this morning. So we're seeing some pressure here on those bonds as they continue to elevate. Bonds suggesting there is more worry on inflation here than the market would like to admit. If we take a look at oil prices here this morning, oil is moving south here this morning. Whoops, let's go to XLE. Moving south here this morning on news that our inventories, crude inventories, have gone up, which is a little bit of concern, obviously, because what that can mean is that the consumers have a lack of demand, meaning that the consumers are stressed and there is a demand problem in oil. So keep an eye on that. Right now, oil futures down $1.33 a barrel. At $70.41, Brent is down $1.31 a barrel at $74.73, and natural gas that bounced around here a little bit yesterday trying to stay bullish, well, it is a little bit lower here this morning, so we'll have to keep an eye on that. Let's take a look at our precious metals here this morning. Boy, gold was a zoomer yesterday, really stretching higher, and right now we've got gold futures looking even higher. Gold futures at this very moment are trading $4.90 an ounce higher here, continuing that run to the upside. Silver had a tremendous run up here in the last few days, but it's showing maybe just a little bit of rest coming into silver with a little bit of a pullback here today. copper's pulling back this morning, palladium's pulling back, and or platinum and also palladium is pulling back here today. So we'll have to keep an eye on that with just a little bit of rest here coming into some of those stocks. And we do need a rest in here. Gold has been running quite a few days. It needs a rest here in gold. So watch that closely. Now crypto this morning is having a kind of a rough day. If we look at BITO, it's not looking like too much over there, but as you can see here in Bitcoin, we are down $1,129 a coin here this morning. Ether is down 48.33 a coin, and we're pretty much right across the board on those cryptos. And I'm guessing one of the reasons that is the case is we're getting quite a bit of, but this is a bad print in here. Don't worry about that big black candle. That's going to change. You can see our prices are back up here. Right now we've got dollar futures are continuing to move up right at this moment, up 57 cents. So watch that closely here. We continue to see the dollar strengthen as a result of those rising bonds. So watch that closely. How about we take a look at these charts? But before we do that, let's settle in and let's buckle up. Let's get ready for the Wednesday edition of the Morning Market Prep video. Good morning once again, everyone, and thank you so much for being here. I very much appreciate it. Let's take a look at these charts, see if we can gain some information about how we might want to approach the market for today. Remember, everyone, we want to look at these charts for what they are, not for what we want them to be. And when we want to be shaking off that bias when we take a peek here on our prep for the day. First off, as you can see, this is a very bullish chart, staying very bullish. Despite this pullback, we're in a bullish pattern here on the diamonds, but we're right on that edge where we could maybe make some decisions here. If the bears were to find enough inspiration. If you take a look right there, pretty nice level of price support in the chart, and you can see we're right here on that trend. So the decision point is now. If the bulls can find inspiration here today, then we're going to have to start pushing up. We need to break back through some of these little areas of resistance in the chart, push back up, and then of course we could push right into all-time highs here in the Dow. However, if the bears continue to find inspiration on these rising bonds and worries there, we're kind of fighting earnings and rising bonds here in the market. The hype on earnings continues to grow as we build in the number of earnings reports, but at the same time these bond yields are creating that pressure. And if we were to see the bonds win out in here, and as I say, something's going to have to break here eventually in this situation. If the bonds win out and we start breaking this down, we've got a nice support right in here on the diamonds to hold support. And if that were to fail, we could come down to the lower side of that to hold that area of support. But let's keep in mind, breaking this trend in here could raise some concern in the market and really raise some fear. So watch that carefully if those bears were to find reason to engage. If we take a look at our SPY also very bullish chart, holding in here on a bullish pattern, holding in here on trends, you can see looking very, very good here at the moment, just a nice little resting consolidation. So if the bulls can find inspiration here today and we can shake off these bond yields, then right up into here and test those highs, and we've got blue skies above, certainly possible in the SPY. However, if those bears were to find some kind of inspiration, then we have that possibility of that slip right here and slip down into that area and break that trend. We could come down here into this area of price support. Now that's a pretty nice area of price support. If we bounced off of that, probably not a major concern, But if that breaks, I suspect we are going to see some fear come up in the market and the selling could become rapid. One of the things we have to remember is that we've got the CTAs are just pretty much maxed out. We've got institutions pretty much maxed out. We've got retail traders pretty much maxed out in this push to the upside. So remember, if the selling starts, it could move quickly and we could see a big run for the door all at once. Now remember, we've got a really strong support down here. So pushing down in here, we could find some pretty good support. But just keeping in mind, fear would be raising pretty high if we end up coming down into that area. And if we take a look at QQQ, our QQQ, still in a very bullish pattern. We're not quite over here to trend yet, so this resting consolidation, no big deal. What is maybe a big deal is if we are unable to break back through that resistance. Because that little resistance right there creates that possibility of a lower high. So we need those bulls to step up here and push this up into this area of the chart. And if they can push past there, then we really have that opportunity that we could attack all-time highs here in the QQQ. And then, of course, blue sky above. And this bullish pattern would suggest that's very possible. Now, if the bears were to find inspiration here today, then pushing this down into this area, probably no major worries if we come down to test that upside trend and that support in the chart. Where we would start to raise some concern is if that area were to break and we were to start coming back down into some of these areas of support. That would probably raise some concern and some fear. And once again, we could see that rush to the door to take profits in this market from not only retail traders, but even the institutions, the CTA computers, all of that to start unloading. And it could happen quickly if it does happen. So make sure you've got those stops set correctly here in the market. If we take a look at the Russell, IWM also showing just a little bit of concern in here. This is still a bullish chart, but a little bit of concern. Pulling back and was unable to break back above this area here of price resistance in the chart after breaking down through it. So we'll want to be watching that pretty carefully. If we were to push on lower here on a bearish move, we could find some support in here, and we could certainly find some support in here. And remember, we still have that upside trend in here. So this has to pull back quite a bit before we really create much in the technical damage. But that doesn't necessarily mean that we can't raise the fear pretty quickly here in the market. Now, if the bulls find inspiration, well, the first step, we need to break through this area of resistance in the chart, start pushing back up. We'll see if we can deal with some of these mid areas of resistance in here and then push right back up here into this level. Remember, this level has been a little bit of a challenge here for IWM, and we did pop through here last time, just weren't able to hold it. So watch that resistance as we push back up. If we can get through there, then we're looking at this resistance here and then on our way up here to test these 2022 highs in IWM. Let's take a look at our VIX here this morning. Our VIX pulled back nicely yesterday. We started up in a little bit of concern with the selling in the market, and I'm guessing we're going to start back up on that VIX here this morning. But the good news at the moment is we're continuing to hold support here in this area. No particular concern there just yet. We still have this downtrend in here to be paying attention to, and so far we haven't been able to break any of that to the upside. Yesterday we pushed up and tested the upper side of that, but then ultimately ended up trading lower. And perhaps the earnings can continue to provide us that bullish inspiration here on the market to hold up here. But we'll want to watch this pretty closely, because fear, if it does spike up in here on a selling wave, that creates a higher low in the market, and we could really see that fear come in pretty strongly. And that's where real selling usually begins in the market. If we take a look at our T21-22, our T20s, we had a nice relief yesterday in that selling, pulling us back here. What was interesting is on the rally back up, we really didn't see much change here. We rallied up into bullish prints just before the close of the day that ended up sinking just right back down into the red. But notice in here on that bullish push that looked like it was huge. It was a big push to the upside. Well, we didn't get a whole lot of change here. Remember, this is the 4-week new high, new low ratio. So what it's telling us is although we had that big pop pushing back up from that selling yesterday, well, we didn't get a whole lot of stocks participating in that to that upside move. So if the bulls find inspiration today, we certainly have plenty of upside opportunity for them to push to the upside. But we do want to recognize that we have more downside opportunity as well for those bears, and they are pushing here this morning, so we could be down here in the bullish reversal zone sometime after the open today. So watch that carefully. Our T2108 here again, T2108 on that big rally back up from the lows of yesterday. Very little response in T2108, meaning that the percentage of stocks above the 40-day really didn't change all that much, and we ended up closing just below our 50% area here in the chart. Just a tiny bit more than half of the stocks are below their 40-day. So a little bit of concern maybe starting to raise here, and with this morning's push down, we could break this little upside trend, and we might be down here testing some other levels of price support in T2108. If the bulls can fight back and bounce back up, well, we've certainly got some resistance up here and some support right in here that they could grab onto if they can find that inspiration on the day and start pushing back up through those levels. T2107, very much the same. Here again, we had that big surge back to the upside yesterday. Boy, it just really didn't show itself in T2107 at all. Percentage of stocks above the 200 barely wiggled back to the upside. But the good news is we did hold on to this price support here in the chart. So if the bulls can grab a hold of that, well, we could certainly start pushing back up and testing some of these levels again to the upside. However, the breakdown this morning, the selling, runs that possibility that we could break that support, maybe start looking for some additional support levels here in the chart. And our T2101, well, doggone it, here again, we really didn't see on that push back up, we really didn't see the breadth of the market go with the bulls here. We did kind of maybe a little bit of a modest hook trying to hold in here, but by the end of the day, we continued to decline in our absolute breadth index, and so we'll want to watch that closely. There just didn't seem to be a whole lot of momentum or true inspiration in that rally yesterday, and we can see this morning those who chased in going to get punished this morning with that whipsaw back down. So just be kind of careful here in our market. Let's take a look at our economic calendar here for today. Now, our economic calendar, we've got a few more things to think about here today on that. We're going to get mortgage applications here this morning. I can't imagine those are going to be great because our bond yields going up, raising those mortgage costs. So I can't imagine those are going to be an awesome number, but we'll wait and see. We've got Bauman that will be speaking this morning. We're going to get existing home sales here this morning, and existing home sales, they are looking for an improvement to 3.9 million in the consensus. Now, I would worry about this one missing just a little bit. With bond yields going up, I'm guessing that we are slowing down in buying homes here. We'll have to see. I'd be surprised the other way, but watch that closely here today. We've got Atlanta Fed business inflation expectations. They were 2.1% last time. We'll have to watch that carefully with rising bond yields. certainly could see that possibility that they could suggest inflation could be going back up. And then, of course, we have our petroleum status number here today. Certainly could be market moving. We've got a bill auction. We've got Barkin. We've got a 20-year bond auction to be paying attention to. That one could be really interesting here today with the bond yields the way they are. Keep a close eye on that. And then we've got a beige book this afternoon to be paying attention to. Looking into Thursday, remember, we're going to get into those jobless claims, Chicago Fed national activity. We're going to have some more Fed speak in here, a PMI, new home sales, natural gas report, Fed balance sheet with some bond auctions here at the end of the day. Let's take a look at our earnings calendar here for today. And our earnings calendar, guys, it is huge. There's just way more stocks here than I can cover in the video. So I want everyone to make sure you click that link just below the title of the video. That'll take you back to the morning blog where you can get that full list of notables. A few highlights here this morning. We are going to... be hearing from AT&T here today. Looks like AT&T is working a move higher here this morning. I already mentioned Coke reporting this morning. We've got General Dynamics in that list. We're going to hear from some utilities, NEE, here today. We're going to hear from ODFL, Old Dominion, on the trucks. So keep an eye on some of those here this morning. Now this afternoon, our most notable is going to be Tesla. We'll want to be keeping an eye on that for this afternoon. We're also going to hear from stocks like Mattel is going to be in there. We're going to hear from stocks like CASH will be in there. PTEN will be in there. TMUS is going to be reporting. So keep an eye on those this afternoon. We've got quite a few in there to be paying. How about we take a look at some stocks that could be setting up for today? But before we do that, everyone, if you could do me that quick favor, if this is the first time you've seen these videos, if you could please click that subscribe button on YouTube and also click that bell icon when it pops up so you'll be notified every time I post a video. And if you do find these videos to be useful or helpful, if you could do me that favor and click that thumbs up button, leave a brief comment. That helps the channel to continue to grow. I do truly, truly appreciate everyone who does that. And of course, it means so much to me. I try to answer those every day. So thank you everyone for your kind support of the effort in putting these videos out. I really appreciate it. Let's take a look at some of these stocks that could be setting up. Remember, guys, these are not recommendations to buy or sell any security. You have to do your own due diligence. You have to make sure that you're trading within your trading guidelines, your tolerance for risk. You should never, ever blindly follow anyone else's trade ideas. Well, first off, let's take a look at Canva here. Carvana had a really good day yesterday, pushing through. You can see I had an alert here on that chart. There's another one of those patterns. By the way, guys, there's videos on this on YouTube. I talk about this quite often. It's part of my 3-8 trap patterns. It's called the pop out of the box, and that pop out of the box is a very strong pattern here. And when it comes in near trend or support, that pop out of the box pattern produces over and over and over to the upside. And when we get a pattern where we get multiples like this, I call this a stepper pattern, where we're just stepping up, just climbing our way to heaven here in these charts. And you can see Carvana doing very, very well yesterday, popping through that alert, possible buy in there if you have an interest in something like that. Take a look at Roku. Roku is also in that pattern where we've got that really tight consolidating box. Still that possibility in here, even though we've slipped past trend. If those bulls can find some inspiration in here and get going, that might pop on through, start stretching up toward this next area of resistance and filling this gap in the chart. Let's take a look at those precious metals here for a second. Now, gold has been a tremendous runner, and you guys know that I have been really loving my gold at the moment. And if you take a look in here on this move to the upside, gold doing very, very well. Now, I would not want to be chasing this, even though we're continuing to stretch and continuing to run to the upside. Any kind of break in those bond yields, anything in here that suggests that the bond market might break, then I would look for this to rest or pull back. It could pull back pretty hard after such a strong move. It could just have some kind of a gentle consolidation in here out to trend to continue to move on higher. I still think this remains bullish in a pullback or consolidation pattern. So I wouldn't throw this chart out, but I would be watching carefully for that potential of that pullback in the chart. And you can take a look at stocks like PHYS, where GLD is really paper gold, PHYS is actual physical gold, and PSLV is another that's just had a tremendous run to the upside. And now I think silver needs a little bit of rest as well. If we look at actual the SLV here, we've got here, I'm going to go all the way back over here to a weekly chart. We've got some resistance coming into this chart, probably right up into here. And we've got this support that we just broke through in that chart to be paying attention to. If we go back to the daily, any kind of rest or consolidation here that rests back on this support and holds in here as we slide out to the trend, I would be looking for that next opportunity. Now, this certainly could pull back pretty hard and break that support in there, and then we're gonna have to wait for another bullish pattern for that to set up. But boy, really strong in those moves. And let's take a look at palladium here. Palladium has been really volatile here lately, bumping around quite a bit. But you'll notice we are continuing to move up in this upside trend here in the chart. And I didn't want to grab that line. I want to stretch it out. So wanting to keep an eye on this, because breaking back through up here, if this were to rest or consolidate in this area up here, then I think there is an opportunity in this rest or consolidation for that next potential move to the upside. I'd keep a pretty close eye on that. Now, I talked a little bit about this morning how Bitcoin is moving lower, but if you're a crypto trader in here, you might want to keep an eye on coin. This nice little formation in here in the chart. Clearly, we still have more work to do. We've got to get through this overall, you know, downtrending situation here in coin. But if you look right across over here, as we push up, we're broke through this resistance. If we can hold some support in this area and maybe rest and consolidate, then look for that next opportunity, possibly for coin. It's not something that I would typically trade at all. I'm not really a crypto fan, but that being said, there are opportunities here. And the same with BITO. If you take a look at BITO, nice little pattern development here. There's that little W formation. We broke through resistance. This is in a pattern that we call a rounded bottom breakout. It's one of my favorite bottoming patterns to trade. And you can see we've pushed up here. We've rested a period of time, allowed all the short-term moving averages to come up underneath that 50 and provide some price support in there. So if those bulls can find some kind of inspiration in here, if we see the dollar begin to weaken or bonds begin to weaken, we might see that move to the upside. So keep an eye on BITO if you're into that crypto world. Take a look at Shopify. Shopify continues to hang in here. I think there's still opportunities there to be paying attention to. I'm liking CPNG still, even though it slipped this support. We're hanging in there on 3 days with just little teeny tiny doji candles trying to hang in there on that upside trend. We need a little bit of bullishness to push us back up. And then I'd be looking for that opportunity maybe here to pick that up in CPNG. Pinterest. Now, Pinterest kind of slipping both support and trend. I have a little bit of concern about this unless it can pop right back up and prove to hold. So keep an eye on that. Now, McDonald's. We've got to talk about McDonald's today. McDonald's was looking great, just fantastic. And then we get news about an E. coli breakout coming in here on McDonald's from their quarter pounder, apparently. Looks like it may be in the onions. The company is responding very quickly to this, but the result of that is obviously pretty darn bearish here in that move, a big breakdown. That's one of those mean things that really happen to us once in a while in the market. We're holding a great winning trade, and then right after the bell, they release that news and dump this thing hard. So watch that carefully. This could bounce around here quite a bit, and it may take some time for McDonald's to recover from this. Be kind of careful. And I also want to mention Starbucks. Starbucks came out with some early numbers suggesting that things are not looking good and should not be a surprise. The new CEO hasn't had enough time to really correct the course of this giant company. But a little bit of selling coming in suggesting that their numbers are not going to look all that great this quarter, it looks like. So watch that carefully. So with that, guys, there's a few stocks for you to look at. I'm running this video long, so I want to wish you all the best. Have a great day. Take care of yourselves, and I'll see you right back here bright and early Thursday morning. And as always, I wish you all the very best.